Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 6.4 in the module Inventory Model, and we are going to discuss the topic Deterministic Inventory Model, model number 4. We will be solving the model and find the solution for the inventory level, optimum time and optimum cost, and we solve problem in the model number 4. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the deterministic inventory model. The model 4, the various assumptions for the model. So it is shortages are allowed, demand rate is uniform, there is finite production rate is finite. The demand rate, the rate of demand is R, the demand of the particular item is represented by capital R per unit time, and the production rate is given by K per unit time, and the model diagrammatically represented like this, and 0 is the start of the process or inventory model. And O to D is the total time for a particular single cycle. So from O to D is the time for particular cycle. O to B is, we divide the entire time into two part, O to B and B to D. Now the green color triangle, we start from here. Now we have demand rate of R and production rate of K. Always the production rate is higher than the demand rate. So as the time proceeds, now the production rate is higher, so the demand rate is lower. So when you produce certain item, certain quantity is consumed, the balance is added to the stock. So the stock is increasing, the stock level is increasing. So the increase in the stock level is given by K minus R. So K is the production rate, R is the demand rate. And the line that represents K minus R, and here it is end. So the production that is completed, it is completely completed. The production that is completed, the total quantity is produced for the entire cycle. Now there is no production rate at point A, there is no production rate. The products are consumed at the rate of R. So the stock level is decreasing. So at the end of the O, at the time O, so this we have half of the time. So at the time, at point A, IM is the stock. So initial inventory level. So this is called as initial inventory level. And now the products are consumed. So there is no production. Products are consumed at the rate of R. So the stock level is continuously decreasing at a uniform rate. And at the point B, there is no stock. There is no item available in the storage yard. Now again the demand is occurring, so there is demand, so the products are taken, but there is a shortage. So this is called a shortage. So B to D, the rectangle BCD is the shortage rectangle. So products are consumed, so the demand rate is decreased, demand they are at a uniform rate R, and up to the point C the product is consumed, so demand rate is satisfied. Now from C again the products are started to, the production rate, production cycle starts. When the production cycle starts, so the products are produced at the rate of K and consumed at the rate of R. So the production is increasing, the stock is increasing at the rate of K minus R. So the slope, these two slopes are equal, K minus R at point D, this is the first cycle. Then the second cycle continues, again the green color triangle will come here, and the red color triangle will come at the bottom of the X axis. So this is the model number 4. So shortage is allowed, and we have the increase in the stock level. So IM is the initial stock level, and Q is the optimum stock level, S is the shortage level. So this is the shortage level, and the total time is T. Now we have to calculate what is the optimum initial inventory level, what is the optimum shortage level, what is the optimum quantity level, QO, what is the optimum QO, and what is the optimum time and what is the optimum cost for the entire model. That is what we have to calculate, the parameter we have to calculate. So the inventory holding cost, inventory holding cost equal to area OAB into holding cost per unit per year. So this is the stock is hold. We are holding the stock here, the green color line. So area of the rectangle, area of the triangle half BH. So half BH means half into B. B equal to OB. OB is the base and H equal to IM. So this is 1 by 2 half B. B is OB and H is IM into C1 is the holding cost per unit per year. So next is the shortage cost. Shortage cost equal to area BCD into shortage cost per unit per year. So the area for the shortage is this triangle. This triangle. So the triangle BCD. So area of the triangle BCD and multiplied by the shortage cost. So there is area of the triangle. So R 1 by 2, the base is BD and the height is S into C2 is the shortage cost per unit time. And setup cost is C3. So we have the holding cost, shortage cost and setup cost. Now the total cost equal to holding cost plus shortage cost plus setup cost. So calculate substituting all the values, C equal to 1 by 2 IM into OB into C1 plus 1 by 2 S into BD into C2 plus C3. So average cost, so C equal to 1 by time. So entire equations divided by the time. So 1 by T half 1 by 2 IM OB C1 plus 1 by 2 S BD into C2 plus C3. So here the time, total time T equal to OB plus BD. So total length of the entire, the time required for entire complete one cycle. Now differentiating partially with respect to Q and equating to 0 will get the optimum lot size. So the previous equation we have to differentiate with respect to Q and equal to 0. So QO equal to square root of C1 plus C2 divided by C2 into K by K minus R into 2 C3 R by C1. And the differentiating partially with this S shortage and equating to 0 will get the optimum shortage level. So SO equal to square root of C1 by C1 plus C2 into K minus R by K into 2 C3 R by C2. The optimum cost equal to CO equal to square root of C2 by C1 plus C2 into K minus R by K into 2 C1 C3 into R. And the optimum time interval TO equal to QO by R equal to square root of C1 plus C2 divided by C2 into K by K minus R into 2 C3 by C1 R. So these are all the parameters we have to calculate. Then optimum initial stock IMO equal to square root of C2 by C1 plus C2 into K minus R by K into 2 C3 R by C1. So all these equations are, required equations are calculated. Now we take a numerical example to calculate various parameters involved in the model number 4. Find the optimum stock level, optimum shortage level, optimum initial stock, optimum time interval between the orders and optimum cost for the following data. Demand rate is 10,000 units per year, production rate is 20,000 units per year, setup cost equal to rupees 400, holding cost C1 equal to 1.6 per unit per year and the shortage cost C2 equal to rupees 18 per unit per year. So the solution, optimum stock level, so QO equal to, you take the equation C1 square root of C1 plus C2 divided by C2 into K by K minus R into 2 C3 R by C1. Substituting all numerical values, square root of 1.6 plus 18 plus 8 divided by 18 into 20,000 divided by 20,000 minus 10,000 into 2 into 400 into 10,000 divided by 1.6. So calculating QO, the optimum stock level equal to 3,299.8, which is equal to 3,300 units. Then optimum shortage level SO equal to square root of C1 by C1 plus C2 into K minus R by K into 2 C3 R by C2. Substituting numerical values 1.6 divided by 1.6 plus 18 into 20,000 minus 10,000 divided by 20,000 into 2 into 400 into 10,000 divided by 18. So calculating SO equal to 134.68 equal to 135 units. Then optimum initial stock IMO. IMO equal to square root of C2 by C1 plus C2 into K minus R by K into 2 C3 R by C1. So substituting numerical values, square root of 18 divided by 1.6 plus 18 into 20,000 minus 10,000 divided by 20,000 into 2 into 400 into 10,000 divided by 1.6. This is equal to 1,515 units. And the optimum time interval TO equal to QO by R 3300 divided by 10,000 equal to 0.33 per 0.33 years. Then optimum cost CO equal to square root of C2 by C1 plus C2 into K minus R by K into 2 C1 C3 into R. So, CO equal to square root of 18 divided by 1.6 plus 18 into 20,000 minus 10,000 divided by 20,000 into 2 into 1.6 into 400 into 10,000. So, CO equal to 2,424.4 rupees 2,424.4, that is the answer. So, these are all the various parameters of the model number 4. We take another example, example number 11, find the optimum stock level, optimum shortage level, optimum initial stock, optimum time interval between the orders and the optimum cost for the following data. Demand rate is 28,000 units, production rate is 35,000 units per year, setup cost C3 equal to rupees 250, holding cost C1 equal to rupees 2.5 per unit per year and shortage cost C2 equal to rupees 22 per unit per year. So, we solve the problem, the optimum stock size or optimum stock level QO equal to square root of C1 plus C2 divided by C2 into K by K minus R into 2 C3 R by C1. So, substituting numerical value is 2.5 plus 22 plus 20 divided by 22 into 35,000 divided by 35,000 minus 28,000 into 2 into 250 into 28,000 divided by 2.5. So, calculating the value QO equal to 5,584 units. And optimum shortage level SO equal to square root of C1 divided by C1 plus C2 into K minus R by K into 2 C3 R by C2. So, SO substituting numerical value shortage optimum shortage level SO equal to square root of 2.5 divided by 2.5 into 2.5 plus 22 into 35,000 minus 28,000 divided by 35,000 into 2 into 250 into 28,000 divided by 22. Calculating SO equal to 114 units. Then optimum initial stock IMO equal to square root of C2 by C1 plus C2 into K minus R by K into 2 C3 R by C1. So, substituting numerical values 22 divided by 2.5 plus 22 into 35,000 minus 28,000 divided by 35,000 into 2 into 250 into 28,000 divided by 2.5. So, calculating IMO equal to 1002.85, which is 1003 units. Then optimum time interval TO equal to QO by R. So, 5584 divided by 28,000 equal to 0.199 years or 0.2 years. Then optimum cost CO equal to square root of C2 divided by C1 plus C2 into K minus R by K into 2 C1 C3 into R. So, substituting numerical value is the optimum cost CO equal to square root of 22 divided by 2.5 plus 22 into 35,000 minus 28,000 divided by 35,000 into 2 into 2.5 into 250 into 28,000. So, calculating CO equal to rupees 6,285.7. So, these are all the answers to the problem. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find this book Operations Research. You can refer to the book for additional information of the subject Operations Research. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better learning. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We will meet again with another model in the inventory model, another video lecture in the inventory model. Until then, bye bye.